talking about White Boy Rick, premiering here at the Toronto Film Festival. You know, what is it about this film that you really think is like the big centerpiece of the movie, like the big draw of it, like what the film is really about? Because there are a lot of moving parts in
yeah,
it.
Yeah, I think the gravitational pull in the movie is family. You know, it's about family.
Yep.
It's about what you'll do for your family, the extent you'll go for your family, the amount of frustration you'll deal with your family, pain, anger, the hate you can have for your family, that's what it's about.
You know, when you're working with someone like Richie, who's making his first, like, it's not just he's making his, you know, it's an acting role, he's in a couple of scenes.
Right.
He's in freaking almost every scene.
It's on his back, yeah.
Yeah, right. I mean, like, what was it like working with him, and you feel like you really felt like he, like, had a big handle of it, or, you know, times where he felt like he needed to work more with Jan and you and just kind of really, like, nail down the scene?
Yeah, he had his process, as everyone does, you know, and you could tell, you know, some days, it was, you know, he's a kid, you know, he was having a great day and he came in, but now it's a serious scene, and he would somehow, in his way, go, okay, this is a serious scene now, you know, what do I need to do for myself to get into the serious, you know, serious mode, you know, what's a serious scene, but, you know, it's a scene in which you can't be smiling right now. You know what I'm saying? Like for the storytelling, what we're photographing, you know, it's best if you don't smile, you know, and he would metabolize that so quickly, you know, and then in metabolizing it, it would go through a system, and like, well, that's not so true to me, maybe I would smile, you know, so he had a certain amount of irreverence to the work, which made it that much more provocative.
You know, because the way the movie is structured, did you ever get to really have time to converse with McConaughey and work out your scenes with him? And
yeah, well, we share maybe 20 seconds on the screen together, you know? And the great part about, you know, Matthew McConaughey, one of the reasons, you know, I believe he is, you know, one of the greatest actors, period, you know, is because of his commitment to the work. And so I don't know if anybody met Matthew McConaughey, you know what I'm saying, while we were at work. I think Rick Singer was there, you know, in the avatar of this Matthew McConaughey. You know what I'm saying? So, but his presence, you know, his presence, his essence, knowing he was working on this with us, you know, was inspiring.
You know, when you have movies like, let's say, Goodfellas, or Boogie Nights, or White Boy Rick, where you see the appeal, the euphoria of getting involved, living that life, living the good life, and then you see it all come crashing down.
Yeah,
like there's an arc to it always.
Yeah,
like what is the, like why do you think that sort of formula always works with telling an amazing story?
Yeah, I think it's a very ancient quality. You know what I'm saying? Everyone wants to be a part of something.
Yeah.
All of us come from all over the world to sit here in Toronto and be a part of this thing. You know, and when you're with people, then what happens, right? You begin to revel. You begin to communicate, and then what happens naturally? Well, what goes up must come down, and the higher up you go, the further you're gonna fall, you know, and what you did while you were up, there will be repercussions and there will be consequences.
Keep moving forward.